Merci, Madame la Présidente. Dear colleagues, in July of last year, I visited the reception and identification center at Moria, Lesbos, in the context of this report. Reception and identification center is the official formal term, but more commonly used, however, is the term hotspot, which sadly better reflects the actual reality of the centres. The Greek hotspots indeed and sadly honour their name, first and foremost because they're overcrowded. Whereas originally the 5 hotspot centres should house 7,500 people, the capacity was reduced to 5,000 by the end of 2017, when in fact they were occupied by more than the double the amount of people. And as the advocacy manager of Doctors Without Borders confirmed to us during our committee meeting of December 2017 in Paris, the overcrowded situation at Moria led to violence, riots, different types of exploitation, abuse and even rape. Female refugees and minors have to be locked into their rooms at night for protection. Besides sexual violence and sexual exploitation, also other forms of organized crime have been reported in the camps. On top of these safety and security issues, the living conditions for the refugees at the Greek hotspots are not humane, as I witnessed with my own eyes. Their housing lacks any actual form of housing. For many months, refugees have to sleep in tents, exposed to rain, wind and cold temperatures. Sanitary provisions are completely inadequate. There are far too few toilets and bathrooms for all the residents in the camp. Food distribution is insufficient. Queues for food are long and waiting times amount up to hours. Health services are lacking. In Camp Moria, there was one doctor for thousands of refugees, meaning refugees were put on a waiting list for several months. This is a situation that I saw last July. Besides the presence and efforts of NGOs, who are often under great pressure and operate with limited resources, this humanitarian crisis is happening on the European continent. This is unacceptable. The mayor of Lesbos even compared Moria to a concentration camp where all human dignity is denied. May I point out to the Assembly that many children, minors and unaccompanied minors are impacted by this crisis. This is of particular concern because to appoint a legal guardian of unaccompanied minors, the Greek law turned to the regional prosecutor in theory or NGOs in practice rather than to individuals. This has shown to be problematic in the past. Moreover, Greece has failed to grant family reunification for all refugees and especially for persons under subsidiary protection. Colleagues, the living conditions for refugees on the Greek islands are so poor that they even lead to death. Still on January 8 of this year, a refugee from Cameroon died in Moria because even with temperatures far below freezing temperatures, people have to sleep in tents in the winter, and we know that there were some deaths in the previous years. Reasons enough for this resolution to express great concern about the situation of asylum seekers in the reception and identification centres. The situation on the Greek islands of Lesbos, Samos and Chios requires our biggest concern. But these kind of centres also exist at the Greek land border with Turkey, where the number of asylum seekers nearly doubled in 2018 to over 10,000. This weekend, last weekend, refugees revolted at that very border, as well as at the border with North Macedonia. These revolts served a call out, both with respect to the problematic EU-Turkey deal, as well as the problematic collaboration between member states of the European Union. Firstly, a new relocation program is needed at the level of the EU to take pressure off countries of first arrival, such as Greece. Other member states should consider admitting asylum seekers or refugees who wish to leave Greece. Moreover, Greek members of parliament hold the EU-Turkey statement responsible for the current humanitarian crisis, especially in the so-called hotspots. On the island, refugees are literally trapped in water-surrounded prisons. Only vulnerable refugees are allowed to leave. It often only concerns ill migrants who are transferred to the Greek mainland for medical treatment. And sadly, this either seems to slow down their asylum process, or out of despair, many of them do not return to the horrible camps and become undocumented migrants in mainland Greece, trying to move on to other countries, which, as I just mentioned, remains impossible as long as no real and new relocation programs are put in place by the EU. Colleagues, the EU-Turkey statement seems to be problematic from many perspectives. This Assembly already expressed its concerns about the living conditions and rights of the refugees living in Turkey, thus questioning the deal itself. This is because readmission agreements should only be in place with so-called safe countries. It should also be noted that the number of migrants reaching Greek soil increased when the bilateral Greek-Turkish relations faced political problems. And in June of last year, Turkey completely and unilaterally denounced, for publicly declared political reasons, its readmission agreement with Greece. Now, the number of migrants stranding on the Greek islands again seems to be increasing. In January of this year only, it concerned more than 2,000 people, and during December last year, it was over 3,000. We should keep in mind that these are only the migrants who survived the dangerous journey, and we should also realize that they often paid a lot of money to smugglers for it. Faced with these persistently high and even rising numbers of migrants, Greece needs the support of the Member States of the Council of Europe and the European Union. Therefore, this resolution calls upon the Greek authorities to immediately improve the housing, sanitary and security situation inside these overcrowded centres, especially on the islands of Lesbos, Samos and Chios. In this respect, NGOs should in all circumstances be granted access to the camps. Also, to ensure that particularly women and unaccompanied minors are better protected. In this respect, effective guardianship and family contact or reunification should be ensured for these minors. In the future, the Greek authorities should duly identify and register all migrants arriving by boat on the Greek islands and transfer asylum applicants that are registered and identified to open accommodation centres on the Greek mainland. Uncontrolled transfers must indeed be stopped. The Greek authorities also finally should set up specific law enforcement units for dealing with organised crime and trafficking and smuggling. These units could also be used to combat what in the past looked like misappropriation of public funds earmarked for assisting refugees. Secondly, the resolution also calls upon the Turkish authorities to identify and register migrants and refugees entering Turkey and share such data, to increase efforts to combat human traffickers and smugglers, and to honour readmission agreements, while at the same time honouring migrants' rights to decent living standards, so that Turkey can rightfully be classified as a so-called safe country. Last but not least, this resolution calls upon the EU to assist Turkey in honouring its readmission agreement, while at the same time introducing a new relocation programme to take off pressure from countries of first arrival and the thousands of asylum seekers who are stuck there. To monitor the effective use of EU funds, also introducing finance programmes of humanitarian projects operated by NGOs, and to assist Greece in managing the external borders of the EU, establishing better asylum procedures on the Greek islands, better accommodating asylum seekers and refugees, implementing family reunification in accordance with the respective directive, concluding readmission agreements with other safe countries of origin, preventing pushbacks of migrants. And finally, we recommend to the Committee of Ministers to invite both Greece and Turkey to continue the readmission of rejected asylum applicants and irregular migrants, and address all sorts of crime and assess the combat against drug trafficking, human trafficking, sexual exploitation, misappropriation of public funds for refugees. In conclusion, I sincerely hope, dear colleagues, that we can make a bold statement here today, because a true humanitarian crisis has been and still is happening on the European continent, a crisis that I have witnessed with my own eyes. We cannot and should not ever accept the presence of camps who are being compared by their respective mayors themselves to concentration camps where all human dignity is denied. We should recall ourselves and all of our peoples that humans have rights, the very rights that we are protecting and defending in this very institution. Humans have rights, and refugees are, besides refugees, also human. I thank you, and once more, I want to thank the Secretariat staff, without whom this report would not have been as accurate. Thank you.